A bill to allow certain staff members in mostly rural school districts to carry concealed weapons on campus is being considered by the state legislature. Joining us tonight is the bill's sponsor, Senator Rich Crandall. And speaking against the bill is Senate Minority Leader Leah Landrum Taylor. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us. All right, why is this necessary?
When you look at school safety, there are several different components. One is you need a mental health component, you need school resource officers, but there's also a component of self-defense, and primarily for your rural districts that are very isolated. For example, Wickiup, the closest law enforcement, is all the way in Kingman.
And you want, so basically because law enforcement is so military, I think you include military in there as well, so far away you want... Who gets to carry these weapons?
So what we did, this is not just something that was thought up over a weekend. It's very thoughtful. We called around the United States, said, who's doing something good in the policy of self-defense? And you go to Texas rural school districts. They've had this policy in place since October of 2007, that a small district that is 30 minutes, 20 miles away from the closest law enforcement can carry, a teacher administrator can carry a weapon, but only after a permit, training. They have some very, very specific rules.
Why not arm teachers, school staff in these small remote schools? Why not?
You know, what I understand about the importance of making sure that we're looking at this whole discussion as it relates to school safety. However, when we're talking about arming the teachers, one of the things that's in this bill is to make sure that the actual school boards would determine who would be eligible to carry these various weapons. I'm very concerned about a school board member actually even in engaging to make a decision like that. Also the fact, and just, you know, the conversation that was just discussed about Texas, there was a recent incident because Texas had decided, let's go ahead and do this. In the middle of this training, a teacher was shot. So, accidentally shot. So, with that being the case, I don't know how much liability we would move with that. I'd rather take a look at safety assessments for each of the schools. That's very important to look at that. Also, on the front end portion of it, about making sure we have enough school counselors, school psychologists. And when you look at the fact that over 73% of the American public in general, with the poll that was taken in January, is not in favor of a teacher carrying a weapon on a school ground. I mean, what kind of weapons are we talking about? I'm very curious to know.
Okay, what kind of weapons? A, and B, correct me if I'm wrong, are we talking about people who are ex-law enforcement or ex-military only, or anyone else that's on staff?
No, it can be anyone else. And so what I did is I called down and spoke to the superintendent of one of these very small school districts. Now, keep in mind, and I love Senator Landrum Taylor, we're very good friends, but on this issue, she's wrong. Because you don't have a school psychologist in a school with 97 kids. You don't have a school counselor in a school. We're talking K-12, 97 kids, 90 kids, 80 kids. You can't afford to have all of those pieces in place. So the bill says it's only pistols or revolvers. It must be carried on them at all times, must have ammunition that doesn't ricochet.
Is it one person or is it anyone on staff?
It could be anyone. And so I called down to Texas, spoke to the superintendent that's had the policy in place for the longest. Said, how do you do it? He says, we go into executive session with the school board. We talk about the individuals who have applied for their school safety program. And they really get in depth on the individuals.
And real quickly, what about this idea of a Texas shooting incident already?
I've never heard of that before, so I'm not sure training along this bill or not.
What do you got there?
Well, it was actually an article that was taken right here. I do have the article if you want to take a peek at it. But a teacher that was accidentally shot during this training. But there's a lot of other issues that go with this. I mean, even AZ Post has a very much of a concern about that, making sure that there's a proper amount of training. With that being the case, who would take on the funding for that? Schools are already strapped with the over $3 billion that's been cut over the last 3 years in education. So how would this happen? And again, it's the determination that a board member would have to make by saying, look, these are the individuals that would be deemed okay to carry these particular weapons. That's a major, major concern, and I'm not quite sure how they would go about doing that. Liability just alone for the various school districts. If this individual accidentally lays that gun down by accident, and there's other articles about that with a security guard that did the same thing, left the gun in a restroom.
If it were narrowed down to, let's say, one person at the school, and if it were narrowed down to saying they had to be ex-law enforcement or they had to be ex-military, something along these lines. And again, we're talking rural areas where you're a far distance away from military and or law enforcement. Would that make a difference?
You know, this bill actually, it's very, very broad because it does open it up to anyone. Quite frankly, there are maybe ways that we could go about partnering in, whether it's with DPS or Highway Patrol, which they're always around as well. If they were in the parking lot, say, for instance, working on paperwork as a deterrent factor to the school that's close by that particular area, there's other ways. But again, you have to look at each school, look at the design of the school, how it's laid out, one entrance in, one entrance out for visitors. There's a lot of things that you could promote in school safety and having an assessment. But going this direction right here, this is very broad.
Please.
One problem we all have when we're both Maricopa County lawmakers, and so we see things through that lens of a Maricopa, a large school district. When I was the Mesa School Board president, we're talking Crown King with 11 students. There is no a school resource officer costs upwards of $70,000, $80,000, $90,000. It's not going to happen. And so for us as lawmakers to say, so you absolutely can do nothing in the area of self-defense, isn't appropriate either. I do agree it needs to be narrow so that it just fits these small certain situations.
But you can partner in, quite frankly, with a school resource officer or a counselor even for someone who's at a high school and at the elementary. There's ways perhaps
Crown King's an hour from anybody. There's no DPS driving by. There's no school counselor. I mean, it's 9 students and you're an hour from the closest anything.
But unfortunately,
there's no DPS passing by. There's no, because there's no highway.
Unfortunately, with this, accidents could occur on the campus. And my thing, again, is this bill is what we're talking about right now. It's extremely broad. We're talking about anyone that could be deemed as okay to be able to carry that weapon. And we don't know. And also in the bill, it states that they have to have looking at the previous reactions to a crisis before they authorize. What if there was never a crisis in the school?
That's not how the bill reads. It says it must consider if there were a previous, how did they respond to that?
Liability issues was raised. Concern?
I called and asked the superintendent. I said, have you had any problems whatsoever in the 6 years you've had this bill in place? He says, absolutely not. We haven't had any problems. And if someone is not carrying their gun, it has to be in their locked car.
Can this bill be narrow? You mentioned how broad it was. Can it be focused a little more?
Oh, it always can be. And it has a ways to go. It still has to go through the Senate whole body and then over to the House. So many opportunities.
Possibility for focus?
I feel that we need to really take a look at different types of threat assessments and looking on the front end of different types of prevention and things that we can. Just because it's a small school does not mean that many of the children may not have a need still for mental health services as well.
Good point.
All right. Well, we'll stop it right there then. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Appreciate it.